that you've been studying consciousness now for over 40 years. So in your opinion, because you know it's almost like this mystic element of our psyche or of our presence or our soul that most people don't understand. But from all of your research and experience, how would you describe it? What is consciousness?
Well, let me first say that most people would say that the brain is a computer, and if you do sufficiently complex computation, the consciousness emerges as some novel property. That's kind of the party line. The other possibility that most people say is that, because that doesn't really explain anything, emergence, you know, like wetness from water or phase transitions, maybe, but there's no prediction of why that would occur. The other possibility people say is panpsychism. So when you get sufficiently complex, you get in touch with consciousness, which is everywhere in the universe. Now that's getting closer, but saying consciousness is a property of matter is wrong. I think I studied these structures called microtubules inside neurons for many years as more computation. It didn't really work. And finally, I read a book by Roger Penrose called The Emperor's New Mind, who had a mechanism for consciousness. And it's kind of a long story, but basically it involves connecting to the fine scale structure of the universe. So in answer to your question, I kind of went roundabout. Consciousness is, in my opinion, organized ripples or waves in the fine scale structure of the universe. We're actually attached, they're connected to the deepest level of reality. And by that, I mean, if you go down in scale, smaller and smaller below atoms, quarks, and whatnot, eventually you get to the basement level where there's some information. It's called the Planck scale. So the universe, space-time geometry has some structure. We know that because it curves due to mass. But what it is, we don't really know, but it has some structure and information there. And this has been talked about in mystical traditions as the Akashic Record or various Platonic values and so forth embedded in the universe. And Roger came up with a mechanism by which, through quantum mechanics, the brain can connect to that deeper level. And when that happens and it organizes, I think that's what consciousness is. Now, it's happening usually between our ears, in the brain, we think because of the microtubule activities. But in the end, we think for conscious awareness, for phenomenal experience, as opposed to behavior. You can do all kinds of complicated things without consciousness. But for conscious awareness, perceptions, feelings, you need this connection to the fine scale structure of the universe. So ripples in the structure of the universe.
So if consciousness is ripples in the structure of the universe, is consciousness out there or is consciousness in here?
Well, the universe is here too.
Yeah.
But according to Roger's theory, to which I subscribe, and we've elaborated on it, these collapses of the wave function are occurring everywhere, ubiquitously, around us, in the table and in the air molecules, and kind of like panpsychism, where consciousness is everywhere, except this is an event. A quantum collapse is where something, particles or space-time begins to separate, but it's unstable and will kind of snap back to one or the other, and that kind of, you can think of it emitting a particle of consciousness, or emitting a quantum of consciousness. But normally these are occurring everywhere and they're random and disconnected and disjointed. There's no memory, they don't amount to much. And what the brain does and what the microtubules do is orchestrate and put it in a meaningful conscious experience. A good metaphor might be if you go to the symphony, let me say I think consciousness is more like music than computation.
Right.
And if you go to the symphony and the orchestra's warming up and each musician is playing his or her instrument, just tuning it, you know, you hear all these funny noises, it's literally a cacophony. That's not music. And that's kind of like what's happening with proto-conscious events here, there, and everywhere in the environment. But then the band begins to play, the symphony begins, and you hear music, whether it's Beethoven or the Beatles, or probably a better analogy would be like a jam session, because you don't need a conductor. It's self-organizing, improv, that sort of thing, jazz or just jamming. And I think that's what the brain does. It takes in information and it has stored information and it all resonates together at this fine scale structure to give it awareness, phenomenal experience.
There you have it, guys. Thanks for tuning in to Unstoppable with me, your host, Kerwin Rae. And please do not forget to subscribe to our YouTube channel where you get to see all of these interviews in the flesh. Share this podcast with your friends. I would love to hear what you guys think. Thanks for joining us.